bank by assets and the largest bank by deposits, two critical indices by which the financial health of the institution can be adjudged. Mr. Speaker, it is very disingenuous that members opposite should come in the Parliament, Mr. Speaker, and attempt not going through the correct route of the question which they are allowed at appropriate time on the other paper, but on the adjournment to, as it were, delay us with speculative comments regarding National Bank. For the record, the bank has issued already at least three public statements regarding the matter over which they seem to be obsessed, Mr. Speaker. Up to today, if the members of the opposite were paying attention, they would realize that the bank issued its third press release, providing an update to the country about what is happening with respect to the cybersecurity incident at the bank. First time in its 50-year history, there has been a cybersecurity of this magnitude. And the bank is working diligently. And that is why the report today, for example, would have pointed to all those services that have been restored. The fact that no one has lost any money at the bank. The fact that they have started basically now to update every individual, every customer account. The fact that, Mr. Speaker, in the management of this situation, the bank is not just relying on expertise over at National Bank. The bank is relying on professional advice, even in terms of what and how it's to be communicated. It is expert, it is specialist in this particular arena that is vetting and drafting every communication that goes out. Because of some point in time, there may be issues of litigation and liability. And therefore, the bank is speaking as it being advised by the best professionals available in this particular arena. And the professionals who are coordinating are persons in the USA, persons in the United Kingdom, Mr. Speaker, insurers, and all those people who have an interest in the integrity of the information that the bank produces. So the bank cannot on its own issue a statement, because there may be implications somewhere down the road when the dust is settled for its insurers. So it's a team of expert people that are managing. Up to yesterday evening, I had conversation with the regulator, the currency union, ECCB. They are involved, they are informed. I asked the governor point blank, do you wish at the political level that I should say something on the matter? He told me no, not at this time. Enough has been said already. The customer's deposit, the bank is assured, is protected. There is no run on the bank. In fact, we have had more deposits than withdrawal during this period. In coming to raise it, and as if there is something being hidden at the bank, is unfortunate. Because we had a run on the bank before. We had that. And so from that experience, we should be guarded as to what should happen and what ought not to happen. We are doing things appropriately. I can assure the depositors and all the customers at the bank that the National Bank leadership is doing everything humanly possible, and there is light at the end of the tunnel. And that is why in reports after report that come out, you're getting an update of the progress. And it is only out of an abundance of caution, Mr. Speaker, that we are waiting for the external parties to give the relevant sign-off and all other areas. So I am not having one sleepless night about it. It is there that I have the little that I have accumulated over the years. and I'm not losing one sleep over that matter, because I have confidence in the management and the leadership of the bank, Mr. Speaker. So I have a copy of the draft press release. It has already gone out.